New here at 5:30, African Americans have been disproportionately impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic. Black people are more likely than white people to die from the virus, yet African Americans are less likely to get vaccinated than many other groups. ABC Action News in-depth reporter Anthony Hill is working to figure out why and what's being done to change this.
COVID-19 has taken the world by storm and has changed the way we live our lives. It's caused mass unemployment, has separated friends and families, and the virus has killed more than 450,000 Americans. The battle to save lives, though, has revealed significant racial disparities in our country's healthcare system. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, Black people are up to 3 times more likely to die from COVID-19 than white people. But of the people vaccinated in Florida, only 5% are Black, even though Blacks represent 16% of the population. The major reason why? Lack of access to the vaccine.
I want my people to get the same thing that I've been able to get.
But there is a contributing factor in the lower vaccination rates. Many Black people are reluctant to even get the vaccine. After digging further, I found a report from the Pew Research Center that said only 42% of African Americans said they would voluntarily get the vaccine once it becomes available. That's less than any other racial group. And many of those people who are reluctant to get the vaccine are among the most vulnerable, older Black people.
So if Black people are disproportionately contracting and dying from COVID-19, why such distrust for the very thing that could save our lives? To find out why, I met up with a University of South Florida professor, an expert in the history of the complicated relationship between Black people and the medical community.
They did not inform these participants that they were part of a study tracing the impact of syphilis over a person's life cycle.
This is USF professor of Africana Studies, Omotayo Jolaosho, talking to me about the Tuskegee experiment. In the early 1900s, syphilis was spreading with no cure in sight. So in 1932, the U.S. Public Health Service decided to conduct a 6-month study using 600 Black men living in Tuskegee, Alabama, as subjects.
They told them that they were going to be getting treatment for bad blood.
The men didn't have quote-unquote bad blood, but hundreds did have syphilis. Medical scientists wanted to observe what would happen if syphilis went untreated, leading up to death. The participants had no idea. In the 6-month study, well, it went on for 40 years.
When the study started, there was no cure for syphilis.
But in the 1940s, penicillin would change the world and emerge as a cure for the sexually transmitted disease.
So even with the knowledge that penicillin would cure syphilis, these men were denied treatment.
The experiment would end in 1972 when a whistleblower exposed what was happening. The government paid a $10 million settlement and a class action lawsuit. This deception still very fresh in the minds of many older African Americans.
What was done cannot be undone.
President Bill Clinton apologizing to the victims and the Black community.
What the United States government did was shameful. And I am sorry.
We have a number of misconceptions.
This is Dr. Deborah Austin from Reach Up Incorporated, a local organization that provides education and access to health care to underserved communities in the Bay Area. They have been providing online discussions about COVID-19 prevention and dispelling myths about the life-saving vaccine. But she says her job isn't easy.
There are elders that we talk to who actually remember the Tuskegee syphilis study and are very skeptical that things like that aren't happening right now. We try to explain to them that there are not policies in place that won't allow that kind of thing to happen again.
She says Black community leaders and pastors have been instrumental and convincing many of the elders to get vaccinated.
Historically, African-Americans have really been challenged when it came to trusting the medical community.
Dr. Kevin Sneed from USF Health is one of the people leading the charge to regain the trust of African-Americans in the Bay Area. Dr. Sneed told me another reason it's essential that Black people get vaccinated is because a lot of us work in the service industry and are frontline workers, making us more likely to contract COVID-19.
Many younger people right now were not around when Tuskegee occurred. They may not even be aware of everything that happened around Tuskegee, but the mistrust has been transferred from one generation to another.
Which is why he is advocating for the vaccine to be brought to African-American communities in the Bay Area. He says with easier access and a rigorous campaign to dispel misinformation about the vaccine, more Black people will be willing to get vaccinated.
Dr. Sneed gave me another reason why it's important the medical community gains the trust of African Americans. If a large number of Black people decide not to get vaccinated, it'll make achieving herd immunity as a country more difficult, essentially putting everyone at risk. In Tampa, I'm in-depth reporter Anthony Hill, ABC Action News.